Chapter 18. King Among Peasants. In the morning he woke up because he heard children's voices. The barn door opened and two little girls came in. They looked at him in surprise. One of them said, "He has a nice face." "And very nice hair too," said the other. "But his clothes are terrible. And how hungry he looks." They came near, and the first girl asked, "Who are you, boy?" "I'm the king," was the answer. With wide open eyes, they stood silent for a minute. "The king? What king?" "The king of England." The girls looked at each other, and then at each other again, and one said, "Did I hear you, Marjorie?" "He says it's the king." "Can I be the true?" "Yes, Percy, I believe him. He is the king." And then they began to ask him questions. They asked him why clothes were bad and where did he go. He told them his story, forgetting even his hunger for time. But when they heard how long he had been with food, they took him for him from mouth to get to see him. The girl's mother received the king very kindly. She allowed him to sit at the family table and eat with them. So he decided that he would also mask of the woman and her daughters to sit in the presence of the king. When breakfast was over, the woman told the king to wash the dishes. He thought that washing beans' food was very easy, but it was not, and he did it very badly. He did everything the woman ordered it to do very badly. He could not do it very well, and we did just to stay in the peasant family. But it was not so easy to regain, because the women may do one thing than another. He was busy all the time. And when after the woman gave a basket with kittens, I told him to go to the river and drown them, he was going to say no. But then he sent Saint John Candy and Hugo. They were coming up to the front gate and did not see. So he took the basket to kittens and quietly went out to the door without a word. He left the basket in the yard and hurried down the long street away from the farmhouse.